Hi guys. So this is a painting of a mermaid. I just got a new microphone, so I just wanted to test it out. This is the second time I've painted this mermaid. The first time I did her in markers and lost all of my footage because I don't know what I'm doing yet. So this one I decided to do it in watercolor and gouache. I put them on the same palette, my watercolors and my gouache. I guess you shouldn't, but I did. So I'm not sure which is which, but it all works out. So right here I'm just painting the background, and I'm trying to get it as even and as smooth as possible. I guess I could have used masking fluid, but I don't like working with masking fluid. I'd rather just paint around all the little fish and shapes and stuff. Which, I guess, if you leave the paper wet enough, it doesn't really leave any of those streaks or hard lines like you get. So, yeah, it works. So, yeah, I just paint the whole background in this color. This is actually the first time I've worked with watercolor in a long time. I stopped a few months back because I was learning how to do acrylics, and I just haven't done one in a while, so this was fun. And as long as I haven't done watercolor, I haven't used watercolor paper for even longer. It's probably been a couple of years at least. Just because when I do my watercolors, I usually do it on hot pressed illustration board. I like it a lot better because it's so smooth. And sorry I go out of frame here sometimes. I'm still getting used to my camera setup. But I much prefer to do watercolor on an illustration board, but I didn't have one. I have a whole pad of watercolor paper that I use for other projects, and yeah, it's good for a lot of stuff. I just don't use it for watercolor. So I have a whole pad of that. I like illustration board a lot better because it's like you can use it with a whole lot of mediums, and it's so smooth, and I don't think it makes much of a difference. But right here, I'm just going around the bottom, trying to make the bottom of the painting darker to make it look like the light's coming from the top, and kind of just painting around all the little coral things right there. It took a while. I was trying so hard not to make this video so long, but if I sped it up any faster, it started being choppy. So I had to cut out a few things, but nothing so critical that you couldn't get the gist of it without it. So I just keep painting around her and trying to keep the paper a little damp so that I can keep blending it so that I don't get any of those hard lines. Just kind of making sure to keep it as smooth as possible. Okay, sorry the lighting changes a lot in this painting. I did it over a couple of days, and the quality of the sunlight varies. I tried to do it early in the morning so that the sunlight wasn't too bright and it wasn't shining right on it. But you can see when it gets towards the end of the video, when the sun's just so bright and there's a lot more shadows, but hopefully it's not too bad. So this is an orange mermaid. What I did was I just went onto Google and Google imaged photos of tropical fish because I think that those are really pretty, and I just wanted to do a tropical fish mermaid. So she's orange with lighter stripes. I guess they're yellow, but I tried to do it like a really cream yellow, which is kind of a cream color. But I think it looks nice with little blue accents. And her hair's green. I'm not sure what kind of fish She is. I think it's kind of like a couple of different fish. I liked the stripes on one and the dots on another, so I kind of just put it together because she's a mermaid, and she doesn't. It doesn't have to be scientifically accurate. Which is a lot of the fun of painting. I haven't. I kind of stopped doing personal paintings just for myself a while back. I was getting a lot of commissions, and I just decided I don't have fun with them. So I'm not going to do many commissions. I just want to paint what I want to paint, you know? So I wanted to paint an orange mermaid. So yeah. And I'm really looking forward to this YouTube channel. It gives me an excuse to paint more for myself and not worry about it. And to have a finished product by the end of it, which is the hardest thing. I'll start so many paintings without finishing them. The hardest thing for me is finishing things. I have so many ideas and I want to paint them all. I'll start so many things and then get an idea right in the middle and start on another one and then never go back to the last one. And I really want to work on that. I want to be able to just sit down and work on a painting and finish it and have it done. And I feel like I've been really productive. Yeah, so the plan is to open an Etsy shop eventually to try to start selling some of my art. And so far, it's been really fun. I feel like I've been more productive. I still have a day job, and it's not bad, but there's not as much time as I'd like to be creative. So I'm really working on making time and making sure that I schedule myself time for art, because that's the hardest thing. You just gotta make time for yourself, and I'm trying to do that, and it can be hard, but hopefully the channel will help, is what I'm hoping. Hopefully at least once a week I want to upload a video, and so that means at least once a week I'll have a finished product, a finished painting, a finished drawing. I don't have a set theme for my channel. I just want to make art. And yeah, that's basically it. I just want to make art. I just want to make so much of it. So, a little more about the painting. There's not much to say about it. I just wanted to do something simple that I could finish in a short amount of time so that the video wouldn't be horrible to edit. But it still took hours. At the bottom there, I didn't record myself painting the ground and the dirt and stuff just because I think that's boring. I don't think you guys would want to watch that. What she's doing is, I guess she found some little, like, pirate doubloons or some kind of treasure, and she's just collecting them, and that's why she looks so excited. I would be too. But yeah, I didn't really plan it out. I just start drawing and see where it goes, and it looked like she found something, so she found something. So I drew some little coins. I hope I did a good job of painting the coins so that people can tell what they are. So here the ground is all painted, and I'm starting to paint in her stripes. I use the some just some yellow and some pink to kind of make a peachy color because I think that's pretty. I think I shaded it with yellow, and I'm pretty sure the stripes are gouache because I did use white. I like the way it looks. I guess a lot of watercolor books say not to use your white paint, but I like it. So right now I think it's in the ugly stage. I think every painting goes through an ugly stage, and that's okay. It's supposed to. I think everybody goes through that, and I still get discouraged, and I think a lot of people get discouraged, and I wish they wouldn't, because if you keep at it, it'll look good in the end, hopefully. And if it doesn't, it's just a painting. It's fine. I didn't record myself putting in the second layer of orange, but that's why it got a little darker suddenly. I didn't like how the first layer was so pale, so I wanted to make it a little more vibrant. Now I'm just adding the little blue details on her, and I think it's ultramarine, which I really like. It's just it's really dark and vibrant, and it's a good contrast with the orange and the cream color. And then I just working on her eyes are going to be the same blue, and just starting to go into the little details, which is my favorite part. So here I'm just adding more shadows. I use a darker orange color, like a vermilion color, but then I go back later and add some purple, just because purple is a... If you put purple on top of orange, it makes brown anyway, so that just gives it more more life, I guess. Instead of just using brown, you use the complementary color? Yeah. And that makes brown for you, so you don't even have to worry about it, and it gives it a little bit more than if you just gone in with brown. You know what I mean. I didn't record myself going in with the colored pencil. I do go in with some colored pencil to clean up the lines a little bit and to add more dimension and definition, like in the hair and on the tail and stuff. I didn't record it because I really didn't want the video to be that long, and it still came out to be like 20 minutes, but I swear I got it going as fast as it can go. But hopefully somebody will stick around to watch it. Yeah, so I'm just kind of working on the tail, and just from now on I'm just adding shadows, and I think I go in later and darken the shadow that's underneath her to make it look like she's really floating above that little outcropping of rock, I guess. But yeah, I think I still need to work on that. And I'm excited to start doing this. That means, like, there's no way I won't improve if I keep doing this. Now I'm just adding more blue details and darkening the eyes and stuff. And I'm just adding more shadows on the face. Usually I start with the face. I don't know why I waited until so long in the painting to go back and add so much detail to her face. It's kind of unlike me, because I love painting faces. I love drawing faces. I love the eyes. I like painting the little details. I don't know why I waited till it was so late in the painting. I guess I was just trying to make sure that the whole thing was going to work. Which, I would have finished it anyway. The hands gave me some trouble, but I think that's common in art. Hands are hard. Hands are just difficult. This is where I'm adding the purple, just to kind of help outline it. Yeah. I really like how this one came out, even though it didn't take me very long. It was just a couple of hours in real time. So, you know, 20 minutes is not that bad, I guess, for a 2 hour long painting. Her hair was originally bluer, but I was afraid that with the water being blue, it would kind of disappear. So originally it was a lot more teal, and this time I just made it more green, and I used a brown colored pencil later on to add little details and shadows and stuff. Just kind of make it a little darker so it would stand out. Okay, and here I've already gone in and added some of the lines with the brown colored pencil. I didn't record it because, you know, it's just outlining what I've already done. I didn't think anybody would want to see that. So I just add more details. I don't record myself painting the coins because I didn't know how long it was going to take, and I didn't think it would be that interesting. I think people would want to watch me draw the mermaid, not the coins. It's just a little detail. Okay, so here the coins are all painted, and I'm going in with that with a darker yellow to kind of fill out the I don't know what they're called. They're just little sea life thingies, little creatures on the bottom of the ocean. I found them on Google Images, and they were really, they're really pretty. I thought the yellow would help bring out the yellow in her tail, and I didn't want her to, I didn't want her tail to be the only yellow in the piece. I thought it would help bring everything together. It just needed more light colors, and then I just add some shadows to the bottom of the bottom edge of the coral, and then later I go in with my highlighter, not highlighter, my gel pen to highlight things. And you gotta paint the little fishies. Those are some little fish that I found in Google Images when I was looking for a reference for the type of fish that I wanted her to be. And so I guess those little yellow fish are kind of the inspiration for her. They've got those little blue dots, and yeah, I just think tropical fish are so pretty. And some little fish in the background, and then yeah. And now we're to the end with just the highlights. So I just her eyes, obviously, and I use it to put in her scales. And that's pretty much it. Yeah, I think I go in later and add some little highlights to the coins, but that's not the most important thing. I really like how this one came out, and thank you so much to whoever watched it all the way through. I know it's a long one, and I'm gonna be working on it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video, which will be sometime next week. I'm thinking I'm gonna upload one every Saturday, because Saturday is a good day for me. Hopefully, if I can do it one earlier, then that's even better. But thank you guys so much, and I'll see you sometime next week.